الله أكبر.
نستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا محمد الله ورسوله أرسله الله بالهدى إلى ناس كافة ودين الحق ليظهره على الدين كله وكفى بالله شهيدا يا أيها الناس تقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا قصيرا ونساء تقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا تقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يُسْلِهِ لَكُمْ أَعْمَالَكُمْ وَيَغْفِرِ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ فَقَدْ فَازَ فَوْزًا عَظِيمًا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا ادْخُلُوا فِي السِّلْمِ كَافَّةً وَلَا تَتَّبِعُوا الْخُطُوَاتِ الشَّيْطَانِ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ أَمَّا بَعْدُ فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ وَخَيْرُ الْهَدْيِ هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ وشر الأمور مقدساتها وكل رث بدعة كل بدعة دلال أيها الناس أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واختسموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله رب العالمين We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this way of life, for this Islam. Had it not been for Allah's guidance, you and I would never have been in any position to guide ourselves into this. And whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide to this way of life, there is actually none that can misguide him. And whosoever Allah in his wisdom left unguided, there is no one that can guide him. And I bear witness that there is no deity or any object worthy of worship but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala alone in his infinite capacity. And I also bear witness openly without any shame that the messenger Muhammad sallam is the last and final messenger sent by Allah to guide mankind after Allah have sent series of messengers. Now what this is Islam, the topic of my khutbah today is going to be the methodology of da'wah. The methodology of da'wah. Now, in the first thing, what is da'wah? Da'wah is an Arabic word which means to invite or to call upon. This word is being used long before the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was commissioned with the Nubuwa. The Arabs, if they want to invite someone for a dinner, for a party, they say, Udu'u, da'awa. But after the dissension of revelation to the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the word da'awa enters into Islam to mean invitation to the way of Allah. The Muslims, Allah in His wisdom, He chooses you and me to be leaders of mankind. كنت خير أمة أخرجت للناس. You are the best of people evolved for mankind. Now the question is, Why are you the best of people? You look so handsome, Allah alone. No, you are the best of people because the Yahud were chosen in time to be the best of nation. But they failed. They failed so miserably. The Nasara was given the chance. They deviated from the path that Allah chooses you. He said, Kuntu khayru ummat. You now are the best of nation chosen to guide mankind. Kuntu khayru ummat. Uhurja linnas. Why would Allah choose you? Allah gave you condition. You don't follow condition, you are not the khayru ummat chosen. Ta'amuruna bil ma'aruf. Wa tanhawna alil munkar. Wa tu'minuna billah. You forbid from doing acts of sin. That is one point to be the khayru ummah. Wa yanhawna alil munkar. And you forbid from all this kind of rancor that is going on. Whatever time you open your mouth, you invite to Allah. You forbid from doing wrong. And then you believe in Allah. Not just believe. You believe and you act upon it. For a guy outside to see the picture of Islam in you, then you are the best of ummah. Allah is wisdom. So if you don't have all these three principles that Allah have laid down, how can you be the best of ummah? You're the best of ummah chosen. Okay, so what? You're going to fold your arm, cross your leg, with a remote control in your hand, changing the channels, eating couch potato. That's why Allah chooses you. No, Allah chooses you to deliver the message. Isa, nicely, beautiful package. Maybe he will listen and he might be guided. That's how you do things. But you don't put people in hell. No, you don't do that. The Messenger Muhammad Sallam spent all these years in Mecca. Never for once did he call somebody, you are a kafir. Nowhere in the Quran, in the Hadith, in the Seerah. Not even half. Because he was sent to guide mankind. Why would you call him kafir? Kafir is the description. If they fall into that category, of course they are. But you as a Muslim who is to guide mankind, you don't go telling you are a kafir, you are a munafiq, you go to hell. The Messenger never did that. Give me one ayah or give me one historic hadith, sahih. No. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا كَافَةً لِلنَّاسِ بَشِيرًا وَنَزِيرًا وَلَكِنَّ أَكْسَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Allahu Akbar. So why would we have to change the system of da'wah? Da'wah is to invite beautifully, smile to the people, look good, present yourself, because anytime you stand in front of the people inviting them, you represent Islam. So your demeanor, you've got to smell good. You have to look good. Don't I look good? Say the truth. I know I look good. You don't have to tell me. Because I represent. Anytime I speak, oh, this is the persona of a Muslim. Yes. The Messenger, he's always smelling good. He's always looking good. He got a lot of hair, but he combed it. He oiled it. Aisha, radiallahu anha, she put oil on his hair to make him look good. And he preferred to spray his body with the opium that is brought from Lebanon. And when we begin to give da'wah, we impress them with so much knowledge. No, you have to listen. The guy doesn't know. He needs guidance. You don't push him by force. Oh, you go to hell. Jesus Christ is you worship Jesus Christ. No, you don't do that. No. The Messenger doesn't do that. That is the minhaj of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So Allah said in the Quran, first with the Ahlul Kitab, قُلْ يَا أَحَلُ الْكِتَابِ تَعَالَوْ إِلَىٰ كَلِمَةٍ سَوَاءٍ بَيْنَنَا وَبَيْنَكُمْ Allah, na'budu illa Allah. ولا نشرك به شيئا ولا يتخذ بعضنا بعضا اربابا من دون الله فان تولوا فقولوا اشهدوا باننا مسلم. Allah gave it the principle, come, because you have a lot of Ahlul Kitab here, the Christian and the non-Muslim. You have them. They are your brothers, they are your sisters, they are your community people. You live together. Some of you have both Muslim and Christian in their family. So what are you going to do? Oh, you go to hell, you worship Jesus. No. You've messed up the da'wah, man. You've messed it up. give him clothes, give him some money, pay for his school fees, smile to him, invite him. He's going to say, wow, Islam is sweet. I think I'm going to join this religion. The Badawi Arabs in Medina, when they came to Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he said, he give them date, he give them something. If they're going up, he give them a ship, he even give them some money. The next time they come, he always giving them. So when they went to the village, they said, man, this new prophet, he gave us as if he's afraid of us, man. As if he's afraid of us. He keep giving. On that note alone, the whole village came. They said, Ashadu Allah, ilaha illallah, wa ashadu annaka Rasulullah ya Muhammad. Beautiful ethic, the rahmah, the mercy. That's why Allah said, فَبِمَا رَحْمَتْ That's why Allah said, فَبِمَا رَحْمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَزَّنْ قَلِيزَ الْقَلْبِ لَنْ فَدْلُوا مِنْ هَوْلُكَ فَعَفُوا عَنُهُمْ وَاسْتَغْفِرُوا لَهُمْ وَشَاوِرْكُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ فَإِذَا أَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ. This ayah was given to Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam by Allah to teach him how to do da'wah. There was a time Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was in Medina, and he was like this in front of the Sahaba, you know, and he began to feel happy in his heart because he see the Sahaba all over around him. So he began to feel happy. Allah said, Jibril, go. Let's teach Muhammad something. So Allah said, فَبِمَا رَحَمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ Because of my mercy, that is why you see them all around you, not you. It is for me. فَبِمَا رَحَمَةٍ مِنَ اللَّهِ لِنْتَ لَهُمْ But let me tell you something, Muhammad. وَلَوْ كُنْتَ فَزَّنْ غَلِيزَ الْقَلْبِ Had it been you are harsh upon them, you're showing them I'm the messenger. لَنْفَلُّ مِنْ هَوْلِكَ The Sahaba will run away from you. You will never find a single man in front of you. Then Allah said, فَعَفُ عَنُهُمْ Have mercy on them. Forgive them. وَاسْتَغْفِرُ لَهُمْ In fact, ask Allah to forgive them because you know more than them. وَشَاوِرْكُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ Call them and have a dialogue. مُشَاوَرَات I can tell you the truth, but I want them to be part and parcel of the whole community so they will feel not left alone. فَعَفُ عَنُهُمْ وَشَاوِرْكُمْ فِي الْأَمْرِ Make مُشَاوَرَات with them. فَإِذَا عَزَمْتَ فَتَوَكَّلْ عَلَى اللَّهِ إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُتَوَكِّلِينَ If you come to conclusion as to the best course you have designed, O Muhammad, then you depend all of on me and I will make the disposition of all your affairs. So this is the methodology. But subhanAllah, to some extent, we have passed away from the methodology of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We have passed that. Wallahi, the Yahud and the Nasara, they got the same thing. Allah have chosen them. Ya Bani Israel, laskulu ni'imati allati an'amtu alaykum wa anni faddatukum ala al-alami. Allahu Akbar. Allah chooses them. At a time that they exist with Musa, Allah chooses them above all nations. Faddatukum ala al-alami. But they failed. They changed the books. They did so many things wrong. They even tried to kill some of their prophet. Then Allah changed them. Bring the Nasara. The Nasara took it upon them, but they forgot most part of the Evangel or the Injil or the good news given to them. They deviated entirely. So now it is your turn. You said Allah is Wahid. Yeah, you have. That is the epitome of da'wah. Tawheed. Every religion is claiming to be on the right. But the only way you can know that the religion is right, that's when you go to Surah Al-Ikhlas. Any religion that comes along, you measure that religion with Quran chapter 112. If you can measure it, that is the criteria for judging a good religion and a bad religion. Number one, whatever religion, you have to assess it with Surah Al-Ikhlas. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Is there a God one or two? Or is it one, but there is someone around the corner who is also a ilaha? You know what I mean? You got to check it out. Say, Qul huwa Allahu ahad. What do they believe? Compare it with that. What do you see? Do you see this and that? That's how you know. Allahu samad. As-samad is someone that doesn't need a chair to sit upon. See, now you're sitting down. You depend on something. I need fresh water to drink after I've spoken for long. I'm not as-samad. As-samad is self-subsistent. You existed out of your own kudra without needing anything. That's as-samad. So whatever Allah they brought along, you measure it. Allahu samad. Okay. If they said this man is the messenger of Allah, okay, but he have mother. He depended on his mother. She breastfeed him. She give him cookies. She give him milk. He's not a samad. A samad is someone who existed out of his own kudra without needing anything. So you measure it. Let me elit. He's not begotten. He doesn't have father. He doesn't have mother. He's وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. He does not have any resemblance. So if you say Allah is Moses, you get a mental picture. You get a picture in your mind. Moses, Israel, he lived and they put him in the water. You have a picture. In Islam, rejected. You say Allah is Isa ibn Maryam. Isa ibn Maryam was born in Jerusalem, you know, in Nazareth. His mother's name is Maryam, and he was born a baby, and she cleaned him up, she breastfeed him. He could not be as-samad. He have a mother. In Islam, rejected. You say Allah is Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which we didn't say. Just give an example. I mean, he was born here, he was born. No, man. So وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. He doesn't have a resemblance. If you say Allah is a spirit, that means you know what a spirit is. No, Allah is not a spirit. Allah is beyond a spirit. If you say Allah is a spirit, you have quantified Allah. Okay, that's spirit. No, Allah is وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. He have no resemblance. That is absolute monotheism. That is tawheed. You hold on to this, you've got no problem at all. أقول قول هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم وأستغفر الله إنه لكم غفور رحيم. إن الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله وأصلي ونسلم على المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا وانفعنا بما علمتنا وزدنا علما. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We thank Allah سبحانه وتعالى. We advise ourselves in this dunya, in the akhirah. There is absolutely nothing in this world. Nothing. What is left is nothing. That nothing is absolutely nothing. So most of the Sahaba and the Prophet, they were practicing zuhud. Zuhud is to run away from this dunya. Isa ibn Maryam, the only Prophet that we know that he have no house to sleep. See, you have your key in your pocket. You have your key, I have my key. When I'm done, I go home, open the door, get inside, turn the TV on, turn the refrigerator on, get some cold water. Isa ibn Maryam does not have a house. He never had a place to call my own. No, he said the earth is his bedrock. That's where he sleep, anytime, anywhere, nightfall, that's his bed, the earth. He said the rocks are his pillows. The sun is his light, the energy, the solar, the sun. His food is the grape, the orange, the lemon. That's all. Isa ibn Maryam, subhanallah, he's one of the ulul azm. There was a time he was walking by the river Jordan. Wallahi, in the Jewish tradition, Haggadah, Mishnah, and Talmud. These are the three Jewish traditional books of translation of antiquity. It's an ancient book about Isa ibn Maryam, reported by men who were there, historians. So Isa ibn Maryam was doing da'wah in the areas of Jordan. So he when he's doing his da'wah, he realized that he was hungry. So he moved a little further north to the River Jordan. Then he saw that his clothes is kind of dirty. Isa ibn Maryam is the only person that have long robe and a pant. And a small something tied here with a calabash with which to eat and drink. So he have only top dress and the pants on the ground, on the pants, and then he have a calabash attached to his waist. Then he stopped. He keep on going from town to town, delivering the message. So he realized that he need to, you know, cleanse up his clothes. He took it out. He washed it by the River Jordan by himself. He put it on the box. He took off the pants. He washed it again. Put it there. It dried. Put it on. Then he began to walk, going into the city to deliver the message. As he was going, he felt thirsty. So he took off the calabash by his waist and he bent down and get some water. When he bent down by the River Jordan to get some water, he was about to drink the water. Then he saw another man at the opposite side of the river using his hand to collect the water. Isa ibn Maryam, he threw away the calabash and he fell down crying for Allah to forgive him. Forgive him what? The calabash. He saw ordinary person at the other side of the river using his hand. And that ordinary person is not a Nabi. He's not a Rasul. He's not part of the Ulul Azm. He says, Subhanallah, look at this poor man with his hand. Me, I have a calabash. I love the world. Ya Allah, forgive me. He was there for the whole day, whole night, praying and crying for Allah to forgive him for attaching himself in this dunya. Right now, you say, Allahu Akbar, yeah. I go to your house, I see your shoe from here to thy kingdom come. I see your closet over here to over here. You know, I see your heart, each cloth is befitting your dress. It's the same?
The same?
The same? Well, may Allah forgive us all. That doesn't mean we shouldn't put on night. Put on. وَأَمَّا بِنِئِمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. If Allah gave you providence, provision, show it. Put it on. You are a rich man, eat good, build a beautiful house. But remember, you're going to leave this dunya eventually. That's the system. All the Sahaba, they did the same thing. So we as a Muslim today, the best way to deliver the message, look, you look at them all around you. Do you like the way they eat? No. Do you like the way they walk? No. Do you like the way they worship? No. So what are you waiting for? When I was coming, I was telling one of my guys, oh man, these are my customers, man. Anytime I see a non-Muslim, man, I want to go. It's my customer. It's my customer. They need the guidance. In their system, Allah have put something called fitrah. Fitrah is the natural inborn mechanism that Allah have embedded in their system to receive the message. They will receive only if you open your mouth. Wallahi, they are waiting for you. Allah have softened them down for you to open your mouth. They will receive it. But who do the da'wah now? Who do? Very few. Da'wah is the key. وَتَكُمْ مِنْكُمْ أُمَّتْ يَدُؤُونَ إِلَى الْخَيْرِ وَيَأْمُرُونَ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَيَنْهَوْنَ عَلِ الْمُنْكَرِ. Let there arise some men amongst you who will invite others into the deen, and these are the successful ones. Allah himself